Well, I got into the FACEIT beta, and now I've played it too much. Better give some of my thoughts. FACEIT adopting TF2 into its library is one of the strangest things to happen this year, but it's honestly really good. With the recent bot epidemic, you can see a lot of veteran players leaving, but strangely enough, the numbers just keep rising and rising on Steam charts, which is a little bit strange. And here comes FACEIT, an alternative to casual matchmaking that offers to get rid of the bots and also make a semi-competitive casual system. So now with FACEIT's private beta being nearly over, I thought I'd give some of my thoughts on it, and honestly, it looks really bright for TF2's future. FACEIT doesn't offer much in terms of maps. I think they don't have enough servers for it, but with the amount of maps that they offer, it seems like a really good map rotation. The small map pool consists of Upward, Badwater, Pier, Boreno, Barn Blitz, Harvest Final, Sunshine, Viaduct, and Dust Bowl. Dust Bowl is a bit of an outlier there, since matches can usually take at least from 5 minutes to 30 minutes plus. So it's a bit weird to have that in a semi-competitive aspect. But otherwise, this map pool is pretty good. If we were to get rid of Dust Bowl, I would honestly add something like Powerhouse, Snowy Coast, Badlands, or Process. And if it absolutely insisted itself to be a attack defense map, just to, sort of diversify the game modes of the map pool, I'd say it'd have to be Gorge or Steel. So how do you actually get into a game? Well, you either use the FACEIT website or the FACEIT client. I much prefer the client, but a strange thing with it is that usually point numbers or leaderboard numbers don't update in time. You usually have to quit and reset the client in order to have it update. This could be fixed later on. It's just a present problem. So once you open up the FACEIT client, you could choose your map pool. Before, this wasn't possible, and there was a long pick ban phase between two randomly picked captains, but they seem to have changed this and made it free for everyone to pick their own map pool. Once the map is picked, or you just join into a lobby that automatically has a map set, there's a lengthy warm-up phase of 3 minutes long. I feel like this should be cut down a little, but honestly, it's fine. And it's, as I found once quoted, a lazy purple server by warm-up and a full-on competitive server when the match starts. Once you get into the game, you might notice a small amount of changes, one of them being no random bullet spread on shotguns. This is absolutely huge, and it makes Scout so much better and makes him the powerhouse that he is in competitive. And another change is no random crits, which it's a weird choice. Most of the chaos of Team Fortress 2 comes from random criticals, and I honestly say it kind of betters the game sometimes. But now that I know that criticals are only coming from a Critskrieg, it's honestly very relieving that it's just not up to random chance that I'm getting one shot by a Crockett. One thing that I see people disliking is the fact that you can't leave. Most people would usually like to leave a casual game if they're getting stomped, and that's very clear that it happens most of the time, especially in FACEIT TF2. And if you do leave, you get put on a cooldown, so it's a bit annoying for people to leave mid-match. And I get that they should be put on a cooldown, but it's a casual mode. There's nothing really at stake. I don't really care. I don't leave games at all. I just like playing TF2. TF2 is TF2 for me. I don't usually take it that seriously. As long as I'm doing reasonably well, I'm having fun. But it is annoying when the top scorer is like, "Oh, my team sucks," and then leaves the game while we're getting stomped. But with FACEIT, I feel like it's the future because it doesn't look like the bots are going anytime soon. It doesn't look like Valve is doing anything to the game recently, and FACEIT is a breath of fresh air. It's really, really nice to have 12v12 casual-ish without all the bots and, the cheating bots. I say casual-ish because there's a lot of people with 1,000+ hours in the game, but I feel like that's just in the beta because the way FACEIT chose it, it seems that a bunch of people who were either high up in the community or have thousands of hours in the game joined it to beta test it. This will obviously change when it fully comes out, and more and more people are going to join with, like, who are newer and experienced at the game. But right now, it's just a total sweat fest, which isn't really that big of a problem. It's still fun. People communicate all the time in these casual games. It's just that sometimes when you're getting stomped, it feels like there's no end to it, because the players know what they're doing. And I also said bots in the cheating sense, because when someone leaves the game, they get replaced with a Valve bot, which, they're good. They're good for on certain classes, like the Medic, the Heavy, and the Engineer bot are some of the best bots in the game. They are always supporting the team, they're always at least getting a few kills. I would say the worst bots have to be the Sniper, the Scout, and the Spy, because usually most of the time they don't know what they're doing, and they either whiff shots completely or just don't get any kills at all. I have found a few bugs while playing the FACEIT beta. Most of this will probably get fixed by the time it ships out in the public, except for maybe one, which is the fact that the FACEIT system cannot calculate ties. So they forced every single game into tournament mode. The way tournament mode works is payload maps, attack defense maps have to reach a certain point. You have to reach a certain point, and once you reach that certain point, it swaps the side, and the enemy team has to reach that certain point even faster, or one point ahead. And this could make games end in literally 5 minutes, because the first team cannot cap past the first point, and the other one just caps in less than a minute, which I've seen on maps like Badwater. This is a very clear problem on Badwater. Most teams either get all the way to last in literally 7 minutes, and then the other team just can't get past first. And clearly, this is just tournament mode, and it's weird sort of like way of working, but having tournament mode is fine. It's honestly fine. It's just a little weird if you're only used to the casual mode, and the fact that it swaps back and forth, and everyone gets an even shot of trying to at least complete the whole map. There is an incentive to complete games. It's not like, oh, I'm done with the first round, my team played like shit, I'm going to leave, I don't care about the cooldown. There is an incentive. There's near daily ladders that offer point bonuses and all that, and once you get these point bonuses, you can spend them in the FACEIT shop, which offers like Australiums, like Capper, even the weird octopus hat that I keep forgetting the name of. And then there's also like a sort of rank up system. You can only get the rewards from it if you're a premium member, of course, but it is cool to see how well you're doing. It is cool to see you actually ranking up in time. Like, I don't have that many matches. I would say, because I got into the beta pretty late, I don't have that many matches. But me reaching whatever rank that I reached once I'm done editing this, I feel self-accomplished. Like, I am actually in the middle tier. I don't know how they're going to change the system, because right now I think it's only gains. But once they do, I think that it would be a good incentive to try and reach up, even with it not giving much unless you're premium. But even with this whole competitive aspect and people wanting to gain points on the ladder and all that, there is still some silliness. TF2 was always like good with silliness and all that. The warm-ups are always like whole friendlies, like everyone's like dancing around doing weird shit with each other, like standing on each other's heads, but they're also in-game. I've had a game where everyone went scout with a pistol and only used it and then just stood in spawn spamming a pistol, and it's the loudest noise ever, but it was still really fun to do that. New comp meta. And then the next round we were on defense, we went all medics and heavies, and it was the Sophia Germanic, uniting together. And it's really fun. even with all of the tryhards, it's still really fun. Even if you're, you know, getting stomped, you still feel like you're improving, and I've definitely felt that, because I haven't played TF2 in that long of a while. I've been playing only casual and doing, like, weird, like, matchups against, like, people who have just installed the game. But now that I'm fighting, like, tryhards in FACEIT, I do feel like I am improving at the game. And in the beta, it wasn't that uncommon to meet some of the same people over and over again. I met the same guy like 3 times in a row, and you know, we friended each other on FACEIT. It's good fun. It's like the old pub days back in like 2014, 2015-ish, where you would join a pub and you would see the same people over and over, and like you would make friends with them and sort of like compare each other's skill and stuff like that. It's a really, really good experience when it comes to that. But the beta was really small, but not necessarily a bad thing. Hell, I was even on a team with Uncle Dane, and also against, one time I was against Fat Magic on Upward. It was really cool to have to like play with all these like new players and all that like that, because usually with the veterans, you usually see them either playing in sixes lobbies or utterly demolishing people in casual, but in very, very small numbers. One problem I could see is if most or all of the veterans move to FACEIT, then the bot problem might take over casual matchmaking, which could maybe kill off the numbers for new players. But if FACEIT were to spread the word more, you know, aggressively, then this could easily just become a replacement for casual. And that's honestly a good thing for how sort of Valve is treating the game right now. And I feel like it's a new coat of paint on TF2, and it's really, really good for the community, because we're finally getting rid of the bots. We're finally have a new interface of doing everything. There's finally an incentive to play the game besides just random drops. And I feel like this is like going to be a new resurgence for TF2. It's not going to be like Creators at TF, which sort of flopped, but it's going to be 100% a new resurgence that will help TF2 sort of rise from the earth again. Even though, of course, right now it's doing pretty well.